I have had ample time to ponder this question all these long years, wandering these halls from witching hour to dawn, with only the creak of foot on the floor and the whisper of the wind through the eaves to keep me company. But in my heart, I am alone.
Patience!
Reginald!
My darling sister, why are you awake at this late, late hour? A beautiful young woman such as yourself should be tucked up in her boudoir as soon as the night cockerel has sungeth his sweet lullaby. Wouldn't you agree, Uncle?
It is not for me to agree or disagree with the choices of man, for I am something beyond humanity now. And when the full moon emerges from the clouds outside, you'll see. You'll both see. Even Mildred will see!
Cousin Patience, I can't sleep.
Cousin Gale, it is far past your bedtime.
Forgive me, but I had such awful night horrors, visions of witches, gargoyles, and communists. Oh, my ghost Patience. Something is wrong. One of you, all of you, you're not meant to be here.
Now, now, back to bed with you.
All right, dear, let me fetch you some bubbly milk and I'll see you back to your slumber.
This is wrong. You're not supposed to be here, you, all of you. You're not supposed to be here!
What the? Barney, I asked you to stop dressing me up when I fall asleep.
Dressing you up?
Ah!
And who is this Barney you speak of?
What? Barney, wake up!
Ow, Pugsley! Pugsley, that hurt! Wait, why are you in black and white? Why is everything in black and white?
Well, it looks the same to me. I think we're in the TV.
In the TV? But this doesn't look like Pauline's insurance commercial.
I just put the young madam back to sleep.
Thank you, Mildred. Now go polish all the silver in the house.
Again?
Hey, Norma! Well, how do we get home? What is that? Who are they?
Ooh, you redecorated. Love the statement wall.
No, Pugsley, that's the fourth wall. Maybe that's the exit?